Welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to create a event calendar using the Bootstrap model. Okay, so in one thing only we'll be doing it. So in my videos playlist of event calendar, we have all done the CRUD thing, update delete, so we will be continuing with that only, with that controller itself. So if you are watching in the event controller thing, so you will get all the controller, like event controller, where we have done the coding of it. Okay, so if you want to know all about this, I have given the link of this event calendar playlist, okay, for the CRUD in my description, so you can just watch it out over there. With this all coding you will understand it. Okay, so now I'm going to use the Bootstrap model to work with this. Okay, so first thing is that make your table and migrations, everything. Okay, so create your event, everything. So please watch out that video with that if you want to work with this model thing. So guys, let's start with that. So go to resource, views, create one new file. So I'm going to create a file called event model .blade.php. Okay, just give enter and your event model.blade.php is ready. So let's start with it. HTML file. Okay, so you will get the structure of the HTML. So guys, now I'm going to design this form little bit and then work on with the add of model. Okay, so guys, go to your getbootstrap.com and click on documentation. Go to the components. You'll get a card. Okay, so I'll design with some card. So header and footer I will take. So I'll take this design. So I'm going to copy this, Control C, and paste in it. Okay, so inside this our event calendar with Bootstrap model. Okay, so now let's work it out and yeah, so let's save this. We'll give in a container. So I'm going to cut this and paste it at last. Done. So now let's view this output. Okay, so for that you have to go to your controller, right? So for that I have already created a controller called event controller with the resource. Okay, so do not forget this wrong. Event controller, yes. So inside that, at index only we have to give the code. So to go till here you have to use your route. Okay, so web.php. so over here I have used the route called resource. Okay, so just forget it about that. So I'll show you. Yes, so just give route resource event controller. Okay, so events it will be, and it will go to events controller. Let's go to the event controller. Add the index, it will go first function. Okay, so so this will give the output, okay, of your event calendar. So we will display the calendar in next video, but in this video we will be storing the data. Okay, so guys, now let's work with that. So what I'm going to do is that I will comment this for your no confusion. Okay, so I have taken this and this, that's it. Okay, so yeah, so I will change this actually because it is events, right? So I'm going to take this and paste it over here. So with the, what happened, so I'm going to copy this events and paste it. Yes, so let's view the output of it. So make sure your artisan is served. PHP artisan serve. Okay, so let's serve it. So I'm using these two only things. Okay, to view it, artisan is served. Now let's see the output of it. Yep. So let's go to events. Okay, click. Event. Yes. Okay, so this is the output now we are getting because we didn't use the bootstrap. What you'll say is that the link over here. Okay, so you have to use the bootstrap things, so you may get the output of it. So first thing is that getting started, you'll get the CSS. So copy this CSS, go to your code and paste it. Okay, so you have got the link, and now you have to paste the scripts. Okay, so these are the scripts. So copy those scripts and paste it at head tag itself. Okay, so it's done now. So guys, now what I'm going to do is that I will take this, I will take all this, cut and paste below the body. Okay, it's done. Yes, so now let's go to our events and reload, and yeah, so it is coming. Okay, so it's in coming in a card format. So guys, now let's design this, I mean work with that calendar to show it. Okay, so let me close this, and yeah, so this is was our card. So I'm going to close all this, I don't need all this. So now I want a bootstrap model. Okay, so let's go to get bootstrap, click on components. So you'll get one model over there, a simple model will take. So that yeah, we'll take this model, launch it. Okay, so I'm going to use this. First I will copy the button. Okay, so paste it, I will paste in the title itself. So this is my title. Inside title I have pasted the model. Okay, so this is my model, I'll mention it as show calendar. Okay, so this is the calendar, and now let's copy the model of it. Button, control C, get back, go down and paste it. So this will be my model. Okay, so this model actually you have not to paste over here, you have to paste at the topmost thing. Okay, so let's paste it top. Done. Okay, so a card is paste, I mean a model is pasted now. So now what you have to do is that see for the ID. Okay, toggle model, example model. So I'm going to tell is show calendar. Okay, oops, so show calendar, control C, just copy this and go to your model, give the ID as show model. Okay, show calendar. So this ID and your button ID should match it. Okay, so it's done now, and now let's view the output of it. So let's get back, go to your browser, and let's show the calendar, and you have getting it. Okay, so let's display the calendar inside it. So guys, as faster we'll do it with that event calendar, we'll name it, it's a very small calendar, so let's make it larger. So you have to just change it one thing over there as you have to use simple thing called model hyphen lg, this is a bootstrap model. Okay, let's save it and go view, and you'll get the large model. Okay, so now let's code the model thing. Okay, so I want to display the calendar, so we'll go inside the model body, create one ID called calendar. Okay, so now in this we will paste the code for it, okay, to view the calendar. So guys, we have already done with that. I'll paste that calendar itself directly. So you have to paste it. Yep. Okay, so this will go to your index thing. Okay, so at event controller, where you just now we commented this code, right? So we have to uncomment this and check with the output. So we have to change this also called calendar. Okay, inside single quotes. Yes. So now what we have to do is that, if you are not understanding about this, please watch out the video of that calendar event CRUD. Okay, calendar event calendar CRUD, inside the description I have given, mentioned it, so you will learn over there. This is just to display in a model, I am working with that. Okay, so as simple, and this is my full calendar script. Okay, so if your version is it might come almost like new versions and all, this is 2.27 version, so I think this is older now. Okay, so now we have to, I have already opened the browser called that is fullcalendar.io. okay, so if you click on downloads, you will get the latest link of it. So I have to just copy that that CDN. okay, for this, so let's paste it, the latest one, calendar. Yes, so after this you have to, if you are using all this, you have to use moment.js and JavaScript. Okay, so first thing, you have to load the first JavaScript, then load this, right? So but JavaScript is below, so let's just crop that JavaScript, or I have already copied the JavaScript file, I will just show you. So I'll paste it now. So guys, yes, so this is my CDN for JavaScript and moment.js. okay, so if you want all this, you can just go to your Google Chrome and type jQuery CDN links, or moment CDN links. Okay, so you will get it, right? So if you just copy that link and paste it in the head section. If you're not pasting in head section, your full calendar doesn't work. Okay, so it will tell that dollar is not found, or jQuery not found. Okay, so it might give some error. So guys, now let's see to view this calendar actually how it looks. So make sure that your web route is set on your event calendar with this much of code. Okay, so yep, and your artisan is served. Now let's go reload the page and see to it the calendar is not working. Okay, let's see why. Let's get it down. Go. Okay, let's see with that error. Okay, so we have initialized two times jQuery, so we have to remove that JavaScript. Okay, so this line you have to remove it. Okay, so just remove that and delete it. Okay, so let's just leave that popper min.js and bootstrap. Okay, for this to work with the model and all. So we are mentioning the script file over here, jQuery and the moment. Okay, so now let's view the output of it. Yeah, now let's refresh and click on calendar. Okay, so we are getting the calendar, but it's not designed. So what we have to do is that go to your full calendar io.js, so you'll get that link of CDN, I mean CDN link of CSS. So let's get with that and type link CSS. So inside this href you have to paste that link. Okay, so just paste it, as simple. Okay, no confusion. So now this is the full calendar script. Reload it once again and show. Boom. So you have got the calendar. So guys, this is in simple way we have got the calendar. Okay, so now we will be adding the event, updating and deleting it. Okay, so let's start with that in the next video. And please, and thank you for watching this video guys. In this video we have completed that how to view the calendar. Okay, so please subscribe my channel, like the video, share the video, and please watch out the next video to add the events in this, okay, calendar. So thank you once again guys.